Onto the mailbox, down, 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 all over the ground, down, down, all over Oscar's trash can. Keep coming down. You're doing good, guys. Keep up the good work. Coming down, down, down onto the banister, all over the steps. But you gotta come down. That's what you're supposed to do. Oh, hi, everybody. I'm really busy. Oh, hi, Maria.
Hi.
Down, you guys.
Big Bird,
you're doing
what are you
very
doing?
Well. Down.
What are you doing?
Oh. No, I'm doing something really important. You see, it's snowing. And I want to make sure that the snow knows that it should come down, 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 down. And so I have this arrow, see? And I'm showing all the little snowflakes that they should come down.
Hey, Big Bird.
Down.
Big Bird, look, in the first place, snowflakes don't have brains, so they couldn't possibly follow your arrow.
Really?
See? And in the second place, they come down automatically. They don't need any help.
You mean, if I don't tell them to come down, you mean they won't go up?
No, no, no. They won't go up, Big Bird. I promise you, they won't.
Okay, if you say so, Maria. Well, all right, you guys. You're on your own. Hope it works.
Snowflakes going up. Nah, it couldn't have been.
And now it's time once again for The Weather Show. And here's the host of our show, that jolly weatherman, Guy Smiley.
That's Yasha. He's a million laughs. Well, let's get right on with our show. You know, most weather shows just tell you what the weather is going to be like. We actually bring you the weather right here on our stage. And now, won't you give a warm welcome to our first performer tonight, that ever popular kind of weather, rain. Play some rain music, Yasha. Yes, sir, isn't it fantastic? Rain is wonderful weather, you know. Rain makes the flowers grow and the trees. And all the plants we need for food. Isn't that great? Of course, it's also kind of wet, right, Yasha? Anyway, let's hear it for rain. And now, folks, straight from a six-month engagement in Chicago, here's our next big guest, wind. Play some wind music, Yasha. Yes, sir, folks, isn't that great weather? Wind's good for blowing all the dead leaves off the trees. And it's great for clearing away smoke and air pollution. And let's not forget what wind does for a kite, right? Of course, it is a little bit cold, isn't it, Yasha? Especially after you've been out there in that rain. Anyway, let's have a great big hand for wind! And now, the moment you've been waiting for, Santa Claus's own kind of weather, your favorite and mine, let's welcome snow! Play the snow music, Yasha! Oh, yeah! Yes, sir, folks, here it is. Wonderful snow. Look at that beautiful snow coming down. It's good for snowballs and snowmen. It's all white and lovely and terribly cold, right, Yasha? Yes, indeed. Okay, let's hear it, everybody, for snow. And now, friends, it's time to find out which of our guests you like the most. Now, everybody clap your hands for the weather you like best. Is it rain? Or is it wind? is it? Snow! It's very easy to see that the winner is snow! Wonderful! Everybody enjoys snow! Kids from everywhere love snow! So tune in next week when we'll bring you another kind of weather. Straight from Miami Beach, we're going to bring you sunshine!
That'd be nice.
You've been watching The Weather Show. Everybody enjoys The Weather Show. Tune in next week and every week when we bring you a straight from all parts of the world. We bring you weather. We bring you weather to look at.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Said the alligator king to his seven sons, I'm feeling mighty down. Whichever of you can cheer me up will get to wear my crown. His first son brought seven oyster pearls from the bottom of the China Sea. The second gave him seven statues of girls with clocks where their stomachs should be. The third son gave him seven rubies from the sheikdom of down there beneath. The king thought the rubies were cherries, and he broke off seven of his teeth. The fourth son tried to cheer him up with seven lemon drops. The king said, I'm sorry, son, since that ruby episode, I just haven't got the chops. The fifth son brought the king perfume in seven fancy silver jars. The king took a whiff and he broke out in spots, cause it smelled like cheap cigars. The sixth son gave him seven diamond rings to wear up on his toes. The king snagged his foot on the royal red rug and crumpled up his nose. The seventh son of the alligator king was a thoughtful little whelp. He said,
Daddy, appears to me that you could use a little help.
Said the alligator king to his seventh son, my son, you win the crown. You didn't bring me diamonds or rubies, but you helped me up when I was down. Take the crown, it's yours, my son. Hope you don't mind the dents. I got it on sale at a discount store. Cost me all of 7 cents. Seven.
Down. 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 Down.
I'd like to tell you a little about the letter S. S stands for more words than any other letter in our alphabet. I'll show you a few. Snow. Santa. Where's the sleigh? Get the sleigh. Sleigh.
You told me you could count. You said there's nothing to it. Well, if you're so good at counting, let me hear you do it.
One, two, three.
Mercy, is that the best you can do? You got to count it higher.
Count it higher.
I'd like to know who told you you could stop at three. You got to count it higher.
Count it higher.
Baby, if you want to count with me, come on, let me hear you count again.
One,
now.
Two, three.
Higher. To count with me. Now let's just try it one last time.
One, two, three.
Cerrado. Cerrado. Cerrado.
Abierto. Abierto. Cerrado. Cerrado.
What if an anteater had long, long legs? And her tail shrunk. And her nose shrunk. And she grew tiny, tiny horns. And a long neck. And many spots. What would she be?
An ant-eating giraffe.
Gonna paint a seven. Seven. Oh. Now wait a minute. Where's my seven?
To talk to you about the word up. U-P. Up. All right. Up is the way this arrow is pointing. Right up into the air. Now let me see. What else can I tell you about up? Well, if you wanted to go away up high, there are several ways you could do it. For instance, can't seem to think of anything. There must be some way to go up. Well, if you wanted to go way high up in the sky, you could. I just don't know what you'd do if you wanted to go way high up in the sky. There must be some way to go way high up in the sky. I hear people talking about it all the time. It's beginning to rain. Rain does not go up. Rain comes down. Maybe I'd better talk about down. Yes, that's what I'll do. Now, most things that go up come down. I hope you've learned something from my little talk. Who put those things in the middle of the sidewalk? Don't they know that's dangerous?
Step right up! Guess your exact weight! Step right up, folks! Step right up! Ah, young man, step right up here. I will guess your exact weight.
You're gonna guess my weight?
Right.
Oh.
I will guess exactly how much you weigh. Let me look at you.
Okay.
Let's see here.
Come on, you take a look. Stop.
Well?
Well?
Well, I would say that you weigh, 3 chickens.
What?
3 chickens.
No, people aren't weighing in chickens, they're weighing in pounds.
Not on my scale they aren't. No? See? This is my scale, and it's marked, in chickens. Now, if the needle comes to here, that is 1 chicken.
Yeah.
Now, if the needle comes here, it's 1, 2 chickens.
Uh-huh.
Now, if the needle goes up to here, it's 1, 2, 3 chickens.
Uh-huh.
Now, if it goes over here, it's 1, 2, 3, 4 chickens. And way over here, if you weigh a lot, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 chickens. But I say you weigh 3 chickens. Would you mind getting on the scale, please?
All right, but this is just silly. I mean, 3 chickens.
There. The needle is stopping, and it's stopping right at 1, 2, 3 chickens. That's just what I said. 3 chickens.
But still, I mean, it's ridiculous. You don't weigh people, and you don't weigh people.
Hey, what's all the racket? What's going on?
You gotta see this.
What?
What he set up. Look at his scale.
Yeah,
I mean, look at it. I mean, it's really funny. I mean, look at that. I mean, he's weighing people. I mean, I mean, you can't weigh people.
Let's see where the needle stops for Gordon. It stops over here. 1, 2, 3, 4 chickens. You weigh 4 chickens, Gordon.
See what I mean? Chickens. I mean, you know, I mean, isn't that funny? I mean, that's Big Bird. That's very funny. Isn't that funny?
That isn't funny. I gained 2 chickens. Now I gotta go on a diet.
Step right up. Guess your weight in chickens.
Go ahead.
Now. A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Don't dance.
H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P.
Slower.
L, M, what?
I said slower.
Well, L, M, N, O, P.
Not that slow.
Q, R, S, T, U, V.
That's nice.
W,
Gloria?
Yes, ma'am.
Too fast that time. Now, just in between the slow one and the fast one, and I think we've got it, child.
The story of The Boy Who Cried Monster. Once upon a time, there was a quiet little village that was worried about a certain monster.
Certainly I'm worried about a monster.
Fellow villagers, this monster that's been stealing our cookies is a real pest.
Yeah, you betcha.
Right on.
He must be stopped. From now on, if anybody sees this monster, just shout, "Monster!" And all the rest of us will come running.
Good idea.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right now, take your bags of cookies home and hide them.
Now in this village lived a mischievous little boy.
Did you hear that? If anybody shouts monster, everybody'll come running. Wouldn't it be nifty if everybody came running here to help me? I think I'll try shouting monster and see what happens. Monster! Help! Monster! Wait a second. Where's the monster, little boy?
Well, actually, there isn't any monster.
What?
No, I just thought it would be nifty to have everybody come running to help me, and it was.
You mean we all came running for nothing? Little boy, we're worried about a monster. We don't have time for games. Please don't do it again.
That's right, yeah. Yeah. Tell him, yeah, that's right. Yeah. I gotta go back to the house now. I was taking a nap, you know, ridiculous. It just
wakes
me up.
Gee, that was fun, wasn't it? In fact, it was so much fun. I think I'll try it again. Monster! Help! Help! Monster! Little boy, where is the monster?
Well, there isn't any monster.
Oh, no.
Well, I had so much fun the last time that I did it again.
Mm-hmm. Well, that does it. We asked you not to do it again, but you did it anyway. Well, you aren't gonna fool us again.
Boy. I wasn't born yesterday.
Beg your pardon?
I said I wasn't born yesterday.
Looked pretty good.
Whole expression. Mm-hmm.
What do you think? Should I try it again?
Just then.
No! What? You're the monster that's been taking all of our cookies.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, good.
No, you don't. The villagers will stop you. Watch what happens. Help! Monster! Help! Help!
I've never done that before.
That old trick, fetches.
We're not coming running this time.
Well? Look like you and me, kid. And you know what? Me take cookies!
Oh, cookies! Help! The monster is eating all my cookies! Oh, why did I ever play that trick on everybody? Now they don't believe the monster is here!
Oh, cookies! Oh, cookies! Oh. Thank you. Oh, cookie!
Blech!
And after that, the little boy was never quite so mischievous again. The end.
Want a cookie?
Yeah, thanks. I'd like
that. Hey, wait, what am I doing? Give me a cookie.
Okay, this time I got you a very difficult question. To answer this, you really gotta be smart. What tool would you use to make this one piece of wood into two pieces of wood? I gotcha. Tell the world you don't know the answer. I finally gotcha. You don't know. I guess I'm gonna have to tell you. You did it again. Okay, so you know you need a saw to get two pieces of wood. But I bet you my new tie, you don't know how to use it. Not so fast, kid! Smart Alec. Next time I'll get you.
Dolls, dolls, dolls. I don't know what that is. They're gonna show us how to make dolls.
That's a baby. My baby. And it can make me.
That color in the eyes.
Color in the eyes.
She puts the eyes on.
Look at your eyes.
Putting the red on. And lips.
Little doggy. Now they're putting the hair on.
Now they're putting the hair on.
Putting on his hair. Putting on a hair. Putting on a hair. Sewing on a hair. Sewing on a hair. Sewing on a hair. Now they're putting the body on. Now they're putting the clothes on.
The clothes on.
Now they're combing the hair.
Now they're combing the hair.
Now they're putting her in the box.
Now they're in the box.
Now they're putting the paper on, the plastic paper on.
And they put in the plastic paper on.
And then they're all ready.
All ready. Cute.
Oh.
Grow and go, roll over the road where the goat explodes all the O's and the crow flies low. Past the croaking toad and the boat floats over the ocean, but the wind did blow and it started to snow. So the toad went home to the telephone. He spoke to the goat who was eating a bowl of bones, potatoes and soap. A rope did float and hook the goat, and a boy climbed the stone made of O's. The O's turned to smoke and started to float closer to the bulldozer, who closed up the hole so the cold wind could not blow. And the sun did show so the roses could grow, and the whole world would know that the boat bulldozer, the toad and the crow, the boy and the rope, right and the goat, were all okay. Okay.
Up, down, up, down, up, down,
up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, up, down.
Can you find an elephant in this picture? That's not an elephant. No, that's not an elephant either. Not an elephant. That's not an elephant. There's the elephant.
Fuzzy face, why are you crying and looking up in the sky?
Cookie.
You want a cookie?
I lost my cookie. I dropped my cookie.
Yeah, but you're looking up in the sky. You mean to tell me that you dropped your cookie and you're looking up in the sky for it?
That's right.
Don't you know the difference between up and down?
Oh, sure.
I don't think you do.
No?
But I know something that might help you.
What?
I know a song all about up and down.
You do?
Yes, I do.
Oh, so do I.
You do?
Uh-huh.
Well, then what are we waiting for? Let's have some music.
Music!
I look up and see a birdie flying high and free.
Well, I look down and then the sidewalk is what I see.
I look up and see the sky.
I look down and see the ground. I look at you and sing a song about up and down. Yeah, I look down and I see bugs and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah, know? I look up and I see a tree.
Hey, I see some ants down there.
Oh, look up there, I see clouds.
Gee,
yeah, you know what else I see? Oh, I look up and see an airplane flying. Yes, I do.
Well, I look down and see my foot, and then I see my shoe.
I look up and see the sky.
I look down and see the ground. I look at you and sing a song about up and down.
You know, I look up, but I can't see my cookie.
Well, you're looking in the wrong direction.
Do I look at you? You want my cookie?
No, 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 I don't
have cookies.
No, no, I don't have a cookie.
Oh, no?
No, no.
Well, you know what? Oh, I look up and see the ceiling, and there's one thing more.
Well, I look down and see the rug, and then I see the floor.
I look up and see the sky.
I look down and see the ground. I look at you and sing a song about up and down. Oh, up, up and down, and down.
Oh, up and down.
You do know the difference between up and down.
Oh, sure I do.
And you sing nice, too.
Oh, thank you.
I've only got one question.
What?
If you dropped your cookie, why were you looking up in the sky to find it?
Oh, because I dropped my cookie and the birdie picked it up and flew away with it up in the sky. Oh, there he is. Birdie, come back, birdie. Oh, drop the cookie at least. Birdie, don't go away with my cookie.
What? What's up, Oscar?
Don't tell me you're gonna shovel the steps.
Well, yeah, I'm gonna shovel the steps. Why?
I told you, don't tell me that. Listen,
what
if you shovel
about?
The steps, all kinds of great things are not gonna happen. You can't shovel those steps.
Hey, Oscar, I don't know what you're talking about. What are you talking about?
Well, just listen here now. Now, just imagine this. If you don't shovel the snow off the steps, someone like Maria, for example, might come out of 123 Sesame Street and start to walk down the steps. Because they're slippery, she would fall.
Well, that's right, Oscar.
And then she might start to cry.
Right again.
And then, you know what could happen next? You'd come along and start yelling at her for being such a crybaby.
Oh, I wouldn't do that, Oscar.
Oh, yeah, you would. You'd do that, Gordon. You'd yell at her, and it would really make her mad for yelling at her when she was crying.
Oh.
So she'd get so mad, she'd probably start throwing snow at you.
Oscar, that would never happen.
No,
now,
then
stop
you'd
it.
Throw snow back at her, and she'd hit you with a snowball, and you'd start throwing snow and be so angry and grouchy.
Oh, come on, Oscar, will you cut
it
out?
Oh, yeah, you'd be so grouchy that Stanley Stinker, Secretary of the Disagreeable Order of Grouches, would hear about it.
Stanley Stinker.
He'd hear that you were such a great grouch, he wouldn't even notice me. Yeah, and then he'd give you the big annual Grouch Award, because you're so rotten and grouchy. And then the beautiful award would go to you. That's not fair. That's really unfair. That's the unfairest thing I ever heard of, all because you wouldn't shovel off your steps.
What do you mean, Oscar? What?
No, I mean, get to work. Start shoveling. That's just get those steps shoveled in.
Oscar, will you please?
Now, start shoveling. After all these years as a faithful grouch, I'm not going to see you get the Grouch Award. Now, keep shoveling. Boy, Maria comes along here, slips. Oh, boy. Shovel, shovel, shovel.
Cerrado. 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 Cerrado.
I was supposed to show you what the word up means. But, well, this is the word up, all right, but it's lying down now. I'll try to push them up. Ah, boy, this word up is heavy. Up now. Up. 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 Ah, there we are. I got them up. You see, up. U-P, up.
And
night, night, Aaron.
Yeah, good night, Bert. Sweet dreams.
Yeah.
Hey, Bert.
Yeah.
What'll we do tomorrow, Bert?
I don't know. Something. Night, Aaron.
You know, Bert, I think I'd like to go to the zoo tomorrow, Bert.
Yeah, well. Okay, we'll go to the zoo, Aaron. Okay?
Oh, good, Bert. Yeah. I'll buy a balloon. You know, they sell balloons at the zoo. I'll buy a balloon. I'll show my balloon to all the animals at the zoo.
Okay. You do that, Ernie.
All the animals at the zoo, I'll show my balloon to. Except for the buffalo, Bert. I'm not going to show my balloon to the buffalo, Bert. You know? Because I'm sort of afraid of buffaloes. They sort of scare me. If I showed that balloon to the buffalo, well, I might be so scared I might let go of the balloon and go way up in the sky. I'd lose my balloon then, Bert. Hey, Bert, listen, I'm going to lose that balloon. Bert, I don't want to go to that crummy old zoo tomorrow.
Okay, have it your own way, Ernie. We won't go to the zoo, okay?
Okay, Bert. Yeah, but maybe some rich man, you know, would see me crying. You know, crying because I lost my balloon when I showed it to the buffalo and got scared. You know, remember that part? And then I bet he'd buy me a new balloon, Bert. Bert, I do want to go to the zoo tomorrow.
Right, Ernie. Zoo it is. Zoo it is, Ernie.
Yeah,
zoo it is.
Good, Bert. But maybe by then, Bert, maybe by then the balloon man would be all out of balloons. Hey, Bert, if I can't have a balloon, I don't want to go to the zoo tomorrow, Bert. No zoo.
Okay, Ernie.
No zoo.
Okay, we won't go to the zoo, okay? Just go to sleep, Ern.
But maybe some boy. There could be a little boy over there. Some little boy over there. I bet some little boy would have two balloons, Bert. I bet if that little boy had two balloons, he'd give me one of them, Bert. You know? Nice kid like that. Hey, Bert, I do want to go to the zoo tomorrow. Good night, Bert.
Good night, Ernie.
Hey, Bert.
Don't tell me. I know. You decided that you don't want to go to the zoo tomorrow, right? I know.
No, I haven't. I want to go to the zoo, Bert.
Good.
But, Bert, what day is tomorrow?
Wednesday, Ernie.
The zoo is closed on Wednesday, Bert. What'll we do tomorrow, Bert?
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Siete. 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 Siete, siete. Siete. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez.
Monkeys.
What if we celebrated Valentine's Day with chickens instead of hearts? Then we would say, I love you with all my chickens.
I left the door open. I didn't lock it. Oh, wow. Oh. Look at that. Someone was in here. Somebody was in here. Well, I left the door open. Look! A note. It says, Dear David, I took some bird seed while you were out, and I left a dollar to pay for it. I'll be back later for my chain. Signed? Nobody signed it. I wonder who... I got an idea. Hey, listen, let's play. I've always wanted to do this. Let's play like we're Sherlock Hemlock and figure everything out. And as he would say, we must use the clues. Now, I came in the door, I hung up my coat, and then I saw, a footprint. Looks familiar, that footprint. Yeah, that's one clue. Now, the next clue I found was the note. Now, what did the note say? It said, I took some bird seed while you were out. He wanted bird seed. That's a definite clue. Look at this. A yellow feather. I got it. That third clue. Do you know what it is? I know what it is. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're probably letting your imagination run away with you. You're probably thinking some strange guy walked in here, all dressed in black with a scarf around his neck, and you're thinking also he had a top hat on. No. I bet you're thinking he had a bird cage with a little yellow bird in it. And the base of the cage looked like a footprint of Big Bird or something. No. You see, the simple truth is it was Big Bird. I know it was Big Bird. Wait, hold it, excuse me. Come in. It was simply Big Bird. Because all the clues add up to Big Bird. Nobody would
have. You must be David.
Yes.
Did you find the note I left?
Yes.
Well, I needed some birdseed right away for my little Leroy. Oh, Leroy, you've lost another feather. Well, there you go. Let me just tuck it in there. Okay. Oh, and I'm sorry. Look at the mess my stand is made on the floor. It's so wet and slippery.
The print,
yes. I'm very sorry. Do you have my change?
Oh, yes, I do. I have your change. I thought you were somebody, the whole print.
Thanks a lot. Ta-ta.
Well, it's time for my nap. You know, naps are nice things, especially if you've got a nice, big, soft, cuddly, fluffy pillow here like I do. And I do. So, just climb into bed here. Mm-hmm.
nice, big, cuddly, soft, fluffy pillow. Shh.
What was that? What was that? It sounded like the bell of a fire engine. Huh. Well, I'll go to the window and see if that was a fire engine bell.
Ah, pillow.
On second thought, if it was a bell of the fire engine, I'd still be hearing it. So I guess it wasn't on a fire engine. So I can go back to my nap again. The bell again, the bell again. Maybe it was the telephone, the telephone. I will go answer the telephone.
Pillow.
But if it was the telephone, Bert would have answered it. So it wasn't the telephone, which means I can go back to my nap and my nice, big, soft, fluffy pillow. The doorbell, the doorbell. Must be the doorbell. I will go answer the doorbell.
Pillow. Pillow.
Nobody was at the door. Hey! What are you doing?
What?
What are you doing with my pillow?
Oh, nice big cuddly soft pillow.
I know it's a nice big cuddly soft pillow, but that's my nice big cuddly soft pillow, and you gotta give it back to me.
I want the pillow. I want the pillow. The pillow. The pillow.
Okay, I tell you what.
What?
How about this?
What?
Suppose we share it.
Share?
You know, share. You know what that means.
Oh,
that, share. That means you take half and I take half.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay. I have half.
Yeah.
And you have half.
Yeah, but
boy. Here's your half.
Yeah, but
it's good. Eat. Oh, good. Oh, boy. Oh, pillow. Oh, pillow. Oh, fluffy. Oh, how you like it? Good.
Stop. What if you were magic and could make things stop just by telling them to, or make them go backwards? Go backwards. Stop. Then you could see what things look like when they're moving. Go forward. Stop. Well, film is magic, and this is a film, so you can be magic for 3 minutes, like this. Go slow, water fountain.
Fly backwards! Stop! Stop! Backwards! S. Snake. Yeah. S.
I'd like to tell you a little about the letter S. S stands for more words than any other letter in our alphabet. I'll show you a few. Snow. Santa. Where's the sleigh? Get the sleigh. Slay.
Hey, Debo.
Yes?
Hey, Debo?
Yes?
What is that there next to you?
S.
Hmm?
S.
That is an S?
Yes.
That? I've got to see this. This over here is S?
Yes.
This is an old friend of mine. Hey, yes, baby! I hope he did not take that personally.
Hey, Maria, cierra la puerta, hace frío. ¿Qué va?
¿Empezó a nevar otra vez?
Sí. Be with you in a minute.
I come from an island where it's always spring, where the waters splash and the parrots sing, and I never, never, ever seen such a thing as snow. I see little feathers falling from the sky, sparkling my hair, blinking my eyes. I've never, never, ever seen such a thing as snow. It takes some getting used to when it's melting on my face. It takes some getting used to when I'm used to the sun of a warmer place.
But now I live on an island where the streets are old, and my room feels empty, and my feet get cold,
and I wish for somewhere better I could go. Then once in a while, something soft and clean falls and covers it over like a quiet scene. And although I'm far from things I love and know, I begin to think, I'm beginning to think I like snow.
Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop. Goodbye.